Tree Spotting episode number 5. Today we go to part 2 of the mystery fig tree, the Ficus Krishnae. If you haven't seen part 1 already, I suggest you actually go and see it, because we've introduced several mysteries of this tree. But if you'd just like to come along from now on, let's do that. Here's a quick recap from part 1. We saw 6 mysteries with this mysterious fig tree, and they were:
why was this tree unknown to botanists till 1896? Who is the Bengali gentleman? Is this a new species or just a variant of the banyan? How does the same parent tree generate 2 kinds of leaves? Why does that one specific tree have leaves with 2 pockets? Why don't the aerial roots reach the ground? If the aerial roots don't reach the ground, how does this tree spread?
So, how does it work then? How did that?
Well, I have a theory.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody's really in any of the literature I've read, mm-hmm. or people I've met, explained this.
Mm-hmm.
I have a theory that the mother trunk mm-hmm. is programmed mm-hmm. to send out horizontal branches. For a certain period in terms of years. Then it is programmed to start looking for the earth, and the branch tends to go towards the earth. If in the programmed period mm-hmm. the branch touches the earth, new roots are formed mm-hmm. and you get a new trunk going vertically. Mm-hmm. If it is infructuous in that programmed period, then the branch automatically and naturally falls off, which is quite different from the way it happens in a banyan tree. And you will notice that wherever the branches have fallen off, they are bending downwards. Now this is the mother trunk.
Mm-hmm.
And look at the way the branch goes out.
Mm-hmm. You're right, the branch is dipping here.
And then where it is dripping, but it fell off naturally because it didn't touch the ground. But there was another portion which did. If in the program period, the branch touches the earth, new roots are formed, mm-hmm. and you get a new trunk going vertically. It drew nutrients from the ground, put out roots, and it's climbing vertically. But see how far it's gone there, and all from the mother trunk. What is important to notice is there is this much similarity with banyans that the branches go out after some time, mm-hmm. after a certain height of growth, mm-hmm. horizontally. Mm-hmm. And here it happens at a very low height of 10 feet. And you can see this has not reached the ground, it's naturally fallen off. And it's going downwards. If what I'm speculating about Arun mm-hmm. is correct, it's an extraordinary thing that this tree has found a new way mm-hmm. of expanding, growing. And even if the mother trunk dies, mm-hmm. these will all continue to live. You see that particular branch is moving linearly and generating new trunks all in one direction towards the east, very clearly. There is a famous banyan tree in Gujarat mm-hmm. where 2 centuries ago mm-hmm. it was in a village. And then it kept going like this, linearly, in one direction. Now it is 2 miles away from where it started.
Can you see how that branch is almost turning to avoid this trunk? Fascinating, it has gone around the trunk and then gone out this way.
Arun, look at the shape of the branches coming out of the mother trunk. It's highly plastic, curved, as though somebody sketched it out and this followed the sketch. It's really an extraordinary formation. And I haven't seen this, and at such a low level mm-hmm. of 10 feet. Mm-hmm. The banyan has no plasticity compared to this. Mm-hmm. It has straight aerial roots or prop roots or trunks. Mm-hmm. But this is all plastic. Like it's searching for something, snaking around, like we've seen here.
Now there's one problem with Vijay's theory. While it does offer a compelling reason to understand the growth of Ficus Krishnae tree number 1, if you look at this other tree with the single trunk and the two pockets, unfortunately this theory doesn't seem to work here. Could it be because it's got two pockets? Who knows?
So, but Vijay, do you think there is a reason why these leaves have pockets, whether one or two, as compared to flat?
Actually, botanists for a long time have discussed this. They have no clear answer. Yes, water can collect in this open jars. And where it does, the leaves are obviously vertical. And insects and ants have been found drinking from that. But in a tree, you will find the leaves go off in many directions, including some facing downwards. That can't be the reason, actual reason. Well, yeah, but it's still not known why it has been created.
Why does nature create a situation where this tree makes pockets, whether it's one or two? Because as you can clearly see, the leaves are not pointing up. These look quite beautiful, these reddish. Are these leaves?
These are leaf sheets. You'll notice on the ground there are hundreds, maybe thousands of leaves which has fallen off. And new leaves are forming. But before the new leaves open out, they come in the form of a leaf sheath. Then the sheath, which is a beautiful sort of pinkish brown color and white, it can be quite beautiful as it opens out. Then the leaf sheath, after it opens out, you have the leaf itself coming out here, you can see, and then it opens out.
Yes.
Where you've broken off the leaf,
yes,
the tree is bleeding latex. This latex is corrosive.
This latex is corrosive?
Yes.
Okay.
It contains an enzyme which is now used as a standard form of meat tenderizer. There must be many, many more uses of the leaves, the bark and the roots, but not enough study has been done about this tree independently. Arun, I'm in a pensive mood now after having done a walk in Lalbagh. I can't tell you how much it means to me, because there's a constant renewal of the mysteries nature throws up for us to try to understand. And the more you study, the more the mysteries, and it's the more you study the mysteries, the more you want to learn about it and try and find the explanation. The more you find explanations, the more applications for those developments within the green world can be found or have been developed. And to me, it's a wonderful, wonderful thing. This is how to put it, a matrix of life itself. To study the Ficus Krishnae. So many unresolved things in our mind about how it has grown. And because it's a recent addition to the plant world, very little work has been done on it. So we are able to speculate and feel we are providing the right answers ourselves, or at least making the right observations. The observations cannot go wrong. And where do we go from there? We either carry out more research work, or, as you've shown in an earlier episode, there could be direct applications into software, so on and so forth, with some of the conclusions you reach. They used to say that Ramanujam's theories and the work in the theory of numbers was worthless. It was something which was a mathematician's delight, but it had no practical applications. Now they found there are 100 applications for almost all his work. The splicing of cables is dependent on one of his Fourier series, so on and so forth. I'm sure we'll come across a lot of this. Maybe with starting with Ficus Krishnae, because very few people have done any study of it. And we're discovering some very interesting things. You know, like even the simple question, why do the aerial roots not come to the ground in this particular tree?
Yes. How long have you observed this tree?
Nearly 20 years.
And in 20 years, you have not seen any aerial root deep in the ground. I mean, a typical banyan tree in 20 years, you would have.
Oh, a large number. And the fact is that it's related to the banyan. So, and it's a new mutation. So why? The question why comes? Why is it veering away, wanting to do something different from its parent stock, so to say? Yes, it's absolutely wonderful. The more you study these trees and plants, it's not even study. You just enjoy walking in nature. And then suddenly something catches your attention. And then that leads to a lot of, it's if I can put it a little crudely, it's a continuous upward spiral of interest and mystery.
And with this, we conclude this episode of Tree Spotting. We have now completed 5 episodes, covered 4 trees, all of them locally available trees in India. And from now on, we're going to actually travel the world and meet some exotic trees that have come from really far away, all the way here to Bangalore. Keep watching Tree Spotting. Subscribe now to this channel.